We believe there have been problems in the way authorities share information. We will cooperate with the authorities concerned so this kind of incident never happens again. We will verify the matter thoroughly in order to develop preventative measures.
The governor said people tend to think the discharge of the suspect came too early, but he said holding him any longer would have created a human rights issue. He said he wants to consult with experts on how to best deal with such a situation. So during Uematsu's stay in the hospital, were proper measures taken? We talked to an expert on forensic psychiatry.
It's hard to say at this point whether this incident was preventable or not. I have to say that there was no problem with him being released from hospital because the doctors saw that he was no longer mentally disturbed at that time.
But Igarashi says the problem is that there is no proper follow-up system after such people are released.
We have to carefully analyze his mental condition and how he was living his life in the period between his release and the attack. And we have to utilize the results to come up with effective measures to prevent this kind of tragedy.
Families of victims and other residents at the home are struggling to process the horror of the attack. Kiyoshi Nakatsuka got a call to say something terrible had happened, but that his son was safe. He raced over to find out more. Nakatsuka says some people learned about the fate of their loved ones on a slip of paper.
The staff handed out pieces of paper to family members and also put a piece of paper on the table.
Sí, veo un tema de las mejillas y la boca.
Ay, qué rico, estoy comiendo yo mi batañito que me gusta, ¿no? Qué gusto, qué gusto.
Cita su fiesta y da ingreso y ella roce, ¿ah?
Pero no era el paso del presidente Pedro Pablo Kuczynski, sino ¿no? Hay diversos policías también que están aquí, que tal vez están haciendo pues que las personas aplaudan y saludan. Mientras tanto, en el estrado donde está la familia, todo continúa con normalidad. Nancy Lange tiene en su mano una bandera que por momentos la agita y también está.